What's up and welcome to another Babymaker production update. This week we do have a global status update for you and we're gonna do something a little bit different. That is sharing your photos of your Babymakers that you've shared in the group from the last week or so. We'll be breaking up the sections of the production update with those photos to keep it exciting. Just a quick reminder before we get going, we do have a live tomorrow at 2 p.m. PDT. That is June 9th. Wednesday, 2 p.m. PDT. Hope to see you there. If you've got any questions, you can ask me live on air. All right, let's get right into this production update. First, we're gonna start it with a couple images from our riders. This one is from Jeff. Looks like a black Babymaker Pro. He says, it is worth the wait. I read that a lot over the past year. Love the stealth aspect. Awesome, Jeff, great photo. And I guess he shot it in 3D too, real cool. From Jason, rode into work today, a beautiful sunny day in Stockport, and that's a tangerine Babymaker with some guitars. Really cool, music to my ears. All right, let's start this global status update with the US C19, that's the ship MOL Prestige. That's arrived at FedEx, the labels have been printed, the bikes have been shipped out, and we're just waiting for tracking on that. That's 54 Babymakers, 825 touring kits. T6-1 and T6-2 both have shipped. We're waiting for tracking on those as well. Those have shipped from FedEx. Both have 225 Babymakers in them for a total of 450 between the two. C20, the OOCL London, the container has arrived at FedEx and will be shipping this week. That's 57 Babymakers and 86 trails. C21, the SM Ningbo, is ETA June 16th, 189 Babymakers plus 220 touring kits, including the Sterling Pro 19 kits for the first time. All right, here's an image from Sogard in Denmark. Just took a little ride in sunny but cold Denmark. Love the bike more and more. After 78 kilometers, the battery is still showing full. That's on paths 1 and 2 and a kilometer on paths 3. Paths, by the way, is pedal assist level. And that's really awesome, awesome range. About, what is that? About 48, 50 miles, I believe, and still showing full. Of course, the battery is not actually full. It's probably more like 60 to 70% in terms of actual range that you'll see from it. But awesome range in those low levels. Sogard, thank you for sharing. All right, Dan from Eden, Utah, some photos of his tangerine Babymaker. He says, I'm 65, weigh 190, 5'11", and out of bike shape, so I use the pedal assist for almost all of my 25 mile outing. Took it up some very steep inclines, but she made it okay. Awesome, Dan. Great photo, thank you for sharing. All right, back in the US, T7-1, 225 Babymakers on the Costco Titan have anchored in Long Beach and we're waiting for those to clear customs, ship to FedEx and then out to your door. T7-2, that's 225 Babymakers on the OOCL Luxembourg. Those are ETA Long Beach, June 14th, as well as T7-3, which is on the same boat and another 225 Babymakers. C22 on the CSCL South China Sea. Those are ETA Long Beach on June 16th with 222 Babymakers. So a lot of bikes incoming and we'll be shipping out very soon over the next week or so here. We've also moved another LCL shipment to Hawaii last week. 6 more bikes for a total of 13 on the water towards Hawaii right now. There are no new ships for the US this week, but containers T8 and C23 are in progress and we'll have more updates for you on those next week. All right, before we jump into Europe, let's see a couple more images from Aaron. It's finally here, one of them at least. So Aaron ordered 2 bikes and got 1 so far, waiting for the hubby to join me. Awesome, Aaron, that is a Sterling Pro, looking real good. Just from looking at this image, I would recommend possibly tilting that seat forward a little bit. Maybe you adjusted it that way. Maybe that's comfortable for you. For me personally, I like to see that a bit more flat. So just a recommendation if that was not intentional. Kevin, I'm having a blast on my Babymaker and find myself getting ride in almost daily. I'm almost done with the modifications. First mod was the Brooks B17 saddle. Got 70 miles on the Brooks and it feels better each day. Kevin, that bike is looking amazing. Really love it. It looks like you might have a speaker in the water bottle mount on the seat tube, which is a great idea. Love to rock those tunes. Really good looking bike. Okay, back into the status update for EU and UK. NL4, which had 129 Babymakers on it, that arrived to the UK on June 2nd. And we are still finalizing the carrier to bring the bikes from the UK to Europe. The carriers are moving a little bit slower on signing paperwork than we had hoped, but we do have good faith in finishing that ASAP. UK 3 arrived at the warehouse today, Monday my time, June 7th. That's 131 Babymakers. We do have the carriers all set to go in the UK, so that should be moving out shortly. SP8, that new nomenclature again, Spain 8, is arriving in the UK June 9th. It's 144 Babymakers. We'll be sending address confirmations today, and those bikes will be mixed between both the UK and Europe in terms of allocation. So when we say Spain 8 coming to the UK, keep in mind those bikes will be mixed for EU and UK. Moving forward, C12, which is a container full of components to build more Babymakers in Spain, that arrived a few weeks ago, and we've just had news that it has completely cleared customs now, which is awesome. We've been building bikes in the background. These are some more reinforcements, and it will give us enough material to build bikes for another 3 weeks or so. So really excited for that, that there weren't big holdups on that container and we can continue building. The next batch of components, which is on container C13, that will be leaving China this week. One more shipment in progress in Spain right now is SP9, Spain 9, which is finishing as we speak. It should be ready towards the end of this week or early next week with a target of 144 Babymakers. That's it for EU UK. Let's see a few more rider images. This one is from William. I don't think it looks quite as good just standing alone, but wow, what a game changer until I decide on different handlebars or maybe just a stem extender. In this configuration, I can sit up much more comfortably and I can use the horns to really get a lot of torque down on the pedals when I want to. Way easier for me to stand up and pedal it like this. Awesome, William, the bike is looking good. And what he's referring to is he's flipped his handlebars over so the horns are arching forward so he can get a nice big grip on those horns. Unconventional, we do ship the bikes with the horns, recommend to install them the other way, but he says it's more comfortable. So you do you, however you like to ride, as long as it's safe and comfortable for you. All the respect for that. Awesome, William. All right, this one's from Robert in Minnesota. With the delivery of the last three Babymakers, the Skittles crew was finally ready for our first group ride. We charged up our lights, waited out a spring storm, and rode to the top of Miner's Mountain. Amazing first adventure of many. Beautiful pictures and awesome to see those Babymakers together, one of each color. Awesome, Robert, thank you for sharing. This one's from Hamid in Vancouver, British Columbia. A great day for a bike ride on my new FLX Babymaker Pro. Looking good, love the cityscape, the water, nice time to ride. Let's get back into the final section of the global status update, LVL, low volume locations. Pretty much everything has shipped there. We're finalizing the input of tracking numbers. There's a few locations where we're still waiting on tracking numbers. A lot of these, because of the complicated shipping channels, it can change hands several times. And that's the reason why it can take several weeks sometimes from shipping until we receive a tracking number that is valid to your door. So if you're in an LVL and you're waiting on a tracking number for a location we have said has shipped already, please hang tight for the tracking numbers. It is probably on its way. There are a few one-offs to special locations where it's very challenging to ship to. We continue working on those. Again, that is just a handful of bikes total. Israel, for example, is a challenging location to ship to, and a couple other islands, small islands. So we'll keep you updated on that. If we need anything from you to finalize shipping of your bike to a special location, we'll be in touch via email. So please stay tuned for that. All right, let's go through a couple more images and then hop into the challenges. This one's from Lyle. He's got the bike, building it here. I got my bike pretty much exactly a year to the day I bought it. Got on the bike this afternoon for his maiden voyage around Sacramento. That's where I'm from, by the way. Love to know what part. Let me tell you, this Babymaker takes off like a car. The pedal assist is awesome. Rode in all of the speeds. 3 is a good cruising speed. I even caught some people on their jump scooters. Awesome, Lyle, really cool. Glad you enjoy the speed. All right, from AV, McKelligan Canyon EP, new stem riser works well for me. So a stem riser, by the way, a lot of folks have been asking about that. How can I raise the handlebars a little bit for a little more upright position? You can look into something called a stem riser or a steering tube extension. That's a piece that will extend the length of that steering tube to raise your handlebars a little bit. You can also look for an adjustable stem if that's something you want to do. You will have to keep in mind there is limited brake cable to work with, so please test it out or check how long your brake cables are before you make that change. You want to make sure it's safe after you adjust it. And it looks like he installed a second seat for a child on the top tube. Really cool to see. Be careful and have fun. All right, another Babymaker with a child seat in back. That's cool. From Carl, big shout out to one of the great members of this group on a seamless transaction. He took a day trip to hand deliver my wife's new bike. Thank you, sir. Now we've got two of these beauties. Can't wait for our family rides. Awesome, Carl. So it sounds like Carl ordered one from us on Indiegogo and got one from inside the group for his wife. Beautiful bikes together, black and pink. Great color combo. Thanks for sharing, Carl. All right, let's jump into the challenges of the week. Overall, very smooth. We are still working on those carriers, like we said, for the UK back into Europe. So fulfillment of those bikes that have already shipped into has been slower than we've expected. However, it hasn't affected bike building, which still is ongoing in Spain. The next challenge is Franco, our guy on the ground in Spain. Unfortunately, has moved to another province of Spain following his girlfriend and their dreams, I suppose. So he will no longer be at the factory. However, things have been very, very smooth there. No challenges with imports on that latest container, C12. So we're gonna keep an eye on that situation, and if needed, Pete, now that travel is okay for the UK, Pete will be headed out to Spain to take care of things there if it's needed. That's it for the challenges. Let's see a couple more images and wrap this update up. From Christopher, added some Velox handlebar wrap for thicker grip and some 128 LED spoke light bars, onto which I loaded a bunch of images. Oh, that's awesome. So it will display images in your wheel when you ride. And that handlebar tape looks really cool. Velox handlebar tape. If anybody is looking to increase the thickness of their bars, that's a cool option. From Marissa, it's been a couple weeks since receiving my Babymaker and I'm in love. I rode to work all of last week. I contributed last May and received my bike as promised this May. San Diego, California. This is my first time contributing to crowdfunding and I have no regrets. I don't leave my bike on the rack since I work night shift and have had a bike stolen before when I put it on the rack. Take it up to where I work. Hey, that's a great idea. Looks like you've got the 19-inch frame, a Babymaker Pro in matte black. Awesome, Marissa. Thanks for the feedback and way to keep your bike safe. I've also had a bike stolen in San Diego, so please be careful out there. Use a thick lock, you guys, if you do leave it out. And whenever possible, take your bike inside with you. That is the best defense against bike thefts. That's it for this week's update, you guys. I hope you enjoy the photos from our riders. Please keep sharing them as bikes arrive. If you're still waiting on your bike, thank you for your patience. More and more are coming, hundreds by the week, so hang tight on those. If you enjoyed the update, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and we'll see you in the next one.